Hello. And welcome to another episode, humble, ever humble, episode of The Analysis. Today we're doing a little runoff from the Oumuamua episode that we did the other day. And it's about, we should heed the warning shot that it really was. All right, bear with me. So, we've already published a detailed article that pointed out the factors that lead us to suspect that Oumuamua is an extraterrestrial vehicle. It got closer to Earth than it did to any other planet. Exactly as we would expect a probe observing us on a flyby trajectory to do. Just a thought, you know. Didn't really act like any asteroid I've ever seen. The ET hypothesis is not the only concern that should make it worth a closer look. For not just conspiracy theorists, us conspiracy theorists, but anyone who is interested in this should go and take a read on our article, as it is a one-stop shop for all the key facts. And our other video was some good musings regarding it as well. So, Oumuamua should serve as an urgent warning to mankind that we could be hit at any time without warning. Anytime. It should be a reminder to us all that we might not see the next object coming. We didn't see this thing coming. What are we doing about this great danger? Nothing. As a species, we tend to put our efforts into other things. And maybe that'll win us the Darwin Award for a species that's unfit to survive. Now, if Oumuamua had hit Earth, we would have had no warning. When we discovered it on October 19th, 2017, it had already passed us by. The impact would have actually been a week earlier on the 14th of October. And from calculations, it probably would have hit somewhere-ish by Australia, in that area. So how much damage would have Oumuamua have done had it hit us? It would have struck the southern hemisphere with cataclysmic results. The analysis researchers have estimated that an object that size, half a mile long and a tenth as wide, traveling that fast, i.e. 196,000 miles per hour as it passed Earth, could unleash an explosion equivalent to 30 megatons of TNT. No, 30 megatons. Nuke Map estimates that an explosion of that magnitude has an air blast diameter of about 8 miles, within which there is a 100% fatality rate and near total destruction of buildings over an area of 55 square miles. Far beyond the main impact, people would receive third-degree burns over an area exceeding 2,000 square miles. And let's just say, for example, that it hit somewhere like Beijing in China. There would have been 7 million casualties, with 5 million people killed by the immediate blast and many more affected by the after effects of the cataclysm. Instantly. If it had landed in the ocean, it could produce a mega tsunami. Russia has studied these while testing tsunami weapons. The Russian Geopolitical Academy has calculated that a 100 megaton warhead could produce a tsunami up to 500 meters high, wiping out all living things up to 1,500 kilometers into U.S. territory. NASA's Near Earth Object Tracking Program is monitoring over 10,000 objects and discovering new ones all the time. 10% of these are over 1 kilometer in size, capable of causing damage on a global scale. And if this thing had come in, it wouldn't have been like in the movies. Asteroids screaming across the sky. You being able to go, this is it. This is it. No. It was going so fucking fast. It would have flown in and vaporized. And just the energy blast of it would have leveled. Have you heard of the asteroid called Apophis? In the year 2029, on Friday the 13th of April, yes, people, Friday the 13th, cannot make this stuff up. Apophis might hit Earth. It will certainly get closer than even some of our communication satellites. NASA admits they cannot rule out a collision with our planet on that date. And it's coming around again in 2036, even closer. If it doesn't hit in 2029, it'll come even closer, 2036. This fucker is an 880 megaton asteroid. Do the math. That is an extinction level event. Period. So, Oumuamua, the space cow, as I've been lovingly referring it by. The space cow Oumuamua, our little cigar-shaped object, reminds us that it's the objects that we haven't seen that are actually the most dangerous, because we would not have even known on October 14th that it was coming. And if it had hit us, well, don't let me ruin your day. I always say, and don't believe a thing I'm saying. Just go check out the information for yourself and give it a chance. Here at The Analysis, we firmly believe that you should think for yourself. We are news that thinks for itself. By all means, do the same. Hope everybody had a good Christmas. And from your humble friends at The Analysis, question everything. And watch out. Forget the weirdos out there. Don't watch out for those weirdos. Watch out for those asteroids. The weirdos, they're not that dangerous. They're really not. It's those guys out there. Ciao.